Alexandria is a white pearl in summer months when it's submerged in water and its villages look like stars surrounded by a shimmering white sea, the Mediterranean. This glorious old city will fascinate you with its beauty and charm as you wander in its captivating streets.
Usually take one last pass through town, stop the car and touch the ground. Watch those streetlights swaying in the breeze. Decorated storefronts, rusty old gates.
Constructed in 1892 by Khedive Abbas II, this mansion was used as a hunting lodge and residence for his companion.
Try to fill my mind up.
The larger Al-Haramlik Palace and Royal Gardens were additional to the Montaza Palace grounds, being built by King Fuad I in 1932 as a summer palace. It is in a mixture of Turkish and Florentine styles, which has two strongholds, one rising characteristically high above with special Italian designing. The palace has long open cloisters facing the sea alongside each floor.
Something for I go. Picture postcard memories. Know they always make for good company. I don't know.
King Farouk ruled Egypt from 1936 until the revolution that brought Nasser to the power in 1952. The king, of course, was intended to be like his counterparts in countries such as Iraq and Jordan, where royal families installed several palaces after the departure of the British colonial administration. The king, obviously, had a home in Egypt's second largest city. Today, that home is still part of the government property, but the surrounding park can be visited for a small fee to let the locals and tourists take a glance of this glorious sight.
Like rain through an old tree or something about a Sunday. Beneath these billboard lines takes me back to those autumn nights. Hometown bleachers packed real tight as we march down the field. The feet would swing from a drumtail.
The stronghold was built in the 1480s by the Sultan Kite Bey on the site of Alexandria's former lighthouse. Parts of the remains of the lighthouse can be noticed in the fundamentals of the old castle. One of the seven wonders of the ancient world, the lighthouse was an astounding construction, 125 meters in height with approximately 300 rooms at the bottom for workers. It also has a container that was used to store water in case of a blockade. Also, located inside the fort is the Naval Museum, which contains artifacts from the Roman and French sea battles.
Out on that front road, real late. No one can walk a line too strong, all right.
Alexandria's antique library was one of the greatest of all classical institutions. However, the recent Bibliotheca Alexandrina occupies a significant importance as well. It manages the same role as its ancestor with ease. Opened in 2002, this extraordinary piece of modern architecture is a deliberate endeavor to revitalize the brilliance of the original foundation of knowledge and culture. The complex has become one of Egypt's major cultural venues, a stage for numerous international performers, and is home to a massive amount of heritage, artifacts, encyclopedias, and museums. Hope you enjoyed this little sightseeing of my hometown, Alexandria. Thank you for watching.